That's an interesting gate. I wonder who built it. Mimir, what can you tell me about that giant lady with the bow?
She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Well, I can just tell you the story later.
Thank you. Rage! done.
If you remember, I started a doozy of a story earlier. It was about Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Bjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
Ulfric. You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones?
Gulvig's...
Really?
Boy.
I can smell...
Boy.
They've taken three of sweet Gulvig's bones.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Bones, child. Gulvig will...
Here we go!
Look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while
if
we...
you wish, boy. I will not be... This chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Arimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Bamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamyr fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord.